So the last time, we were just saying, the last time we spoke, it was London, 2 a.m. on the floor in the dark of my hotel room where my best friend slept in the bed, and she had work at 6 a.m. Mm-hmm. So I didn't want to be too loud. And it turns out you were also in an awkward situation.
Oh, yeah. I was definitely at a friend's house who's an actor, and I was in their bathroom just like walking around listening to the acoustics. Terrible service in the house as
well. Terrible both ways.
So just like walking around the bathtub and like you're on a floor talking quietly. Yeah. I was sitting there like, wow, we're being so professional right now.
We are. I mean, we could be doing anything with our lives. Mm-hmm. We could be running a cruise ship through the Mediterranean. It just came to me. And yet here we are being professionals, making it work, fitting it in with our normal everyday lives.
Roll with the punches, right?
Exactly. Technology. So take me to back to the moment when your album debuts at number one on top of the Billboard album chart. That's got to be pretty like...
Definitely a super weird moment. The weirder moment of that moment though was finding out that it was the first female record of that year to go number one, of which of course was completely eradicated because Katie followed and then Lauren followed, and then Alana's here and then you know what I mean. It was like, which is so awesome,
of course,
and like it was kind of this whirlwind where I was like excited and happy and really proud of myself, but also pissed, like,
yeah,
where's all the women at, where you know what we? I mean, like, yeah, kind of mad, but it was cool to like dethrone some of those like men that have been sitting on top of the charts for a while. I mean, it was really bizarre. It's like, you know, you have this feeling before you're making your second record where you're like, are people still going to like me?
Of
like,
course.
Was this a fluke thing? Was I a phase? Was I a fad? Like, are people still going to care, you know? And then you settle into this, like, comfortability that's like, all right, you don't wake up with that anxiety that's like, this could go away at any minute. Now it's just like, all right, I'm here. My fans aren't going anywhere. I get to make art. This is your life. Pinch me, I'm dreaming. Like, just do the best you can.
There's so much in that that I want to explore. Yeah. But we'll start with women in music, because this, in Australia just recently, there's been a lot of discussion about the fact that I think we've had like one solo female on top of our charts in like the last 12 months or something. It's just disgusting. And I get this question all the time, and it's the same in radio. I think I'm the only solo female that has a national show. I can't think, I might be wrong. No, I'm pretty sure I'm right. It's just not a thing. And it's like, it's a man and a woman, or it's two men and a woman, or, you know what I mean? It's not token, but it's not like around. And people say, what do you think it is? For me, I think it's like, I don't know, growing up, I have the idea that guys kind of like fake it till they make it a bit more, but women, we're so much harder on ourselves. Like, no, I don't deserve that. Or I want to wait till I know that I'm good enough before I put myself out there. Did you ever face anything like that where it was like, you know, and sometimes it's not really obvious to you until you can kind of look back and go, man, I think that did have something to do with it. Or can you just be proud now and go, you know, well, I am what I am and gender has nothing to do with it?
I am proud, but also at the same time, you definitely are harder on yourself as a woman. I think that like in the industry for men, like, I know so many talented male artists that have just, you know, changed the course of music, and like people like Ed Sheeran or Drake or Kendrick, like, you know what I mean? People that have just like completely changed the face of what it means to be a musician. But at the same time, like being a woman, I think that you are required to be just so overwhelmingly unique.
Yeah.
Like, it's crazy. Like, if you're a man, like, you can wear the same suit as every other guy at the award show. But if you're a woman and you wear the same color dress as someone else, it's a headline. Are you trying to be like them?
Yeah.
And it's like, there's just like that mentality of like, there's not enough room for more than,
so
you know,
true,
more than one female to be a certain way. It's like, you know, a lot of these male artists, they could sing about the same thing or write with the same people or dress the same, the same backup dancers and the same whatever
and
else.
And then you do it, like, and you're a one trick pony.
Yeah, or like, you know, if you're, there's, we only have room for one of this or one of this or one of this, like, especially from like a genre perspective, it's like there's one alternative female, there's one country female, there's one rap female, there's one pop female, one R&B soul female, and like there only gets to be one, and then there's just like so many.
Yeah. Dudes. So how do you think a large part of it is that it's not enough for us women to keep talking about it? My personal view is it's nothing's going to change until men start to recognize that it's our issue together. It's not just a women thing, it's a human thing. And once they start saying, hey, there actually is a disparity here, nothing's going to change, right?
No, for sure. Because if they act like nothing's wrong because it's benefiting them, that's you know, elevating the problem in a way. And it's like, I know it's been happening in film a bit. You know, there's a lot of male actors taking pay cuts to see their female co-stars be, you know, more accurately compensated. And that's, I think that's really amazing and really powerful. I think I've seen some male artists really uplifting other female artists, which is great. You know, Kendrick's been really, really outspoken about SZA, who put out an incredible record this
She's
year.
She's amazing.
A in incredible record. I'm so happy that she's having this moment
because yeah, she's been up for a VMA. For so long. She's, best new artist.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Honestly, like it's well deserved because it's an amazing record and she wrote it herself. And, you know, she's just like a force to be reckoned with. And, you know, he's been uplifting her in that way. And I think that's really special. But I think that's it as well, is that there needs to be stop being this ownership. It needs to be like, I'm uplifting this female because I think she's great, not because I own her or because she's the female version of me or because she's whatever. Like, that needs to go away.
Totally.
You know what I mean? There's like a female artist comes out and it's like, she's the female version of blah, blah. It's like,
no, she's just doing her thing, man.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. So I do think that there's like a responsibility on male artists to do that. And also on female artists too, to uplift each other. You know what I mean? That's been like a big thing. I'm taking Charlie XCX on tour in the fall in the States. And I think she's brilliant. She's a great writer, great girl. She's got sick style. She's so unique. She's so very much herself. And like, you know, knowing that I get to do a tour with a woman like that is like, we're gonna have the sickest time.
You will. Know? And what I love about Charlie is that she writes music that she likes. Mm-hmm. She doesn't write pop radio bangers.
Yeah.
Some of the things like we get, and you kind of like the normal people go, there's no hook, or we can't, that's not a radio hit. She's like, I like it, I don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And I think we need more of that, because when I think authenticity trumps everything.
For sure.
If you put something out that's real and authentic to you, people in this day and age especially, they respond to that. And I think that's part of the reason your album has resonated so well with people.
Thank you.